Hey everyone, it's Deja from crocheteverafter.com. Today is a new free pattern workshop, and this is the baby bear beanie. So this is sized for newborns, or probably like 0 to 3 months. It's about a 15 inch circumference. I will tell you how you can make it bigger so it will last a little longer, but this is a cute little 3D bear ear beanie that would look so cute in any baby shower gift basket. So we're using medium worsted weight yarn, a 6 millimeter USJ hook, and a little bit of polyfill. If you don't have polyfill, you can use scrap yarn. I'll explain that later, and we'll get started. So download the pattern in the link below, and we will get started.
All right, so to get started, we're gonna use some Vanna's Choice from Lion Brand. I like Vanna's Choice for acrylic because it's pretty soft, it's nice and washable, and it comes in a lot of different colors. The colors change a lot with this brand as well, so if you don't find the exact color, which was taupe, you'll find something that's very similar to it. So it's a good good brand. I really like the actual yarn, so it holds up really well. I have some projects from years and years ago, and it still looks really good. So we are going to start with a magic adjustable loop. Favorite thing for beanies because it creates a completely closed hole that you don't see anything through on the top, and this is going to be the top of the beanie. So we're going to take our yarn in our hands. The easiest way for me to explain the magic adjustable loop is to kind of put your tail on the bottom, hold the yarn in your hand, and take the hand that's holding the loop and just turn it down so it crosses over, and then grab that cross and insert your hook through that loop you just made. Then you're going to pull up the loop that's attached to your working yarn, pull that up, and kind of just pull everything close together and tight. And you can either slip stitch, just pull it through and tighten it down to lock it in, and then you don't have to worry about losing your loop. Or you can just start doing your first instruction, which is a chain three. So the chain three is gonna count as a double crochet. So I'm gonna go ahead and do three chains. So yarn over, turn your hook down, pull through, three of those. And then we're gonna do 11 more double crochets. Let me adjust my light here. I'm like in the dark over here. That's a little better. All right, so we're gonna make sure you keep this kind of pretzel twist to your yarn. Don't let this tail fall out. You can close your hole down a little bit if you want that a little longer so it's not falling out. Just pull on it and it'll close your hole down. Then we're going to do 11 double crochets into this loop. So we yarn over, insert our hook into that big loop, grab our yarn. So you notice I just kind of lay it over the top. There's no like wrapping or doing anything crazy. Just lay it right over the top and turn your hook a little to grab it and then pull it up. Kind of adjust everything as you're going because you want to keep your stitches close to one another so they stay a consistent size. So we yarn over and then we pull through the first two. Then yarn over and pull through the second two. So our first double crochet is made. We're going to do another 10 of those. So yarn over, insert through the loop, lay over your yarn. You'll see that it kind of just does it on its own as you work. Pull up a loop. I always work off at a 45 degree angle. I point down and pull through the first two. That way my stitches stay the same size as my shaft, and then I get stitches that are all the same height. Again, reach through, pull up, pull everything close to one another. If I make my double crochet really far out like this, if I just start double crocheting where I'm at, then I get this double crochet that's way over there, and I pull it over, and you'll see that it's a little bit taller and looser than my others. So I want to keep them close to one another on the loop, even though my loop is huge. I can close it down a little if I want, because I'm definitely not going to need that much. And we have four. So if you're new to crocheting and you're not sure how to count your stitches, double crochets are easy to count because they have this gigantic post that you can kind of pull apart and you can see each one. So the chain three counts as a stitch and each post counts as a stitch, but you can also turn your work and count the top of the stitches, which look like the letter V. So we have one, don't count the one on your loop, that's just a working loop. We have one, two, three, and then four is the top of the chain three. So let's do another eight, and then we will join to do our next round. All right, here's my 12th, 12th double crochet, didn't need that. And now we have kind of a rainbow, but we're gonna turn that into a circle with a completely closed hole by grabbing our tail. And then I just grab the very last stitch I made, I grab it down by where the loop is to hold it, and then just pull it closed. Just keep pulling and pulling until it's completely closed and our circle joins up. Don't worry if it comes open while you're working. Once you weave it in, it's gonna stay closed. So as you're working, this is probably gonna come a little open. Just pull it again and it will close down. So we're gonna join with a slip stitch in the top of our chain three. So I know where it's at because I'm used to it, but if you don't, the first one might be a little small, but here's my first chain, second chain, third chain. Another thing you can do if it's really hard to see is count backwards, count your V's. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So that 12th is my very first, and that's where I want to join for my slip stitch. So I insert my hook under, yarn over. Again, it's like a layover. It's not like wrapping around a bunch. Just lay it over the top, pull it down, pull it through, and then pull it through the loop on your hook. So that is my very first round. You'll see my little hole already opened up a little bit, but I can just pull on that and it will close up. Now for the round two, what we're gonna do is a tall chain. So I like to do tall chains because it masks the chain three look and the seam of your beanie. So normally you would do a chain three and then you would double crochet, and I'll explain this part in a second. And it gives kind of like a skimpy looking stitch. If I do instead a tall chain, I'm gonna get something that looks a lot better. So a tall chain is basically a chain, you're gonna pull the height of a double crochet. It's better to go smaller than bigger than your double crochet. It'll be more hidden if it's a little bit smaller than bigger than a normal size double crochet. We're gonna lock in that tall chain with another chain. So yarn over and then pull through. And that is gonna be our tall chain that's gonna not count as a stitch. This does not count as a stitch. So when we do our instruction, we go straight into the double crochets. So it's telling me to double crochet two times in every single stitch around. So because this doesn't count as a stitch, I need to work two double crochets in the stitch that I just joined with. So I'm gonna yarn over. The hole is nice and big for me from that tall chain. I can insert right in and do a double crochet. And then I'm going to yarn over and do another one in that same hole. This is going to increase it so it lays nice and flat, or the crown will be nice and flat on the baby's head so you don't have like a cone head effect. Then we're going to do two double crochets in the next stitch. The next stitch is always the most difficult to see when you're working in rounds because it kind of gets pulled a little strangely from your join. So you can see I have kind of a big hole there. I don't want to work into just that loop because that's just the back loop. I want to work into this front loop too. So you can see the V's are coming together and then this one's kind of a little distorted. So I want to get under that first loop and the back loop. And you can always pull to make sure you're only under two loops. And then do my two double crochets. So once you do the first one, the easy one, the second one's easy to see because then you have the hole there. So again, I'm going to my next stitch and this one's a lot easier to see. The hole's already opening up for me. I just insert under both those loops. You can try just the front loop or the back loop. It's just gonna give it a different texture. If you do the back loop, you'll have little ridges. So this front loop will be like a ridge all the way around. If you work into the front loop, it just kind of flattens it out. There'll be, it doesn't look too much different than this because you're working in the round. So the back loop's really the only thing that's gonna give you a different look. So if you find that you have ridges around your beanie and it doesn't look like mine, you're probably only working in that back loop. But if you like the look, then do that. So we're going to keep going with two double crochets all the way around. Okay, just finished my last two double crochets. Now I'm ready to join. So when you have your tall chain, here's my tall chain right here. You can see it's kind of blended in. You just ignore it. All it's doing is providing you with a way to get your first stitch the same height as the rest of your stitches. I could have just started double crocheting into this space, but it would have been really squished down because there is no height to start off your stitch with. So we ignore the tall chain and we join with a slip stitch in our very first double crochet. So again, if you're new and it's hard to find that, work backwards, count your V's until you get to number 24, which is right here, and slip stitch under both of those loops. So pull through and pull through, and I tighten it down just so that brings everything together. So you can see that my seam is almost invisible and you don't see those chain three stitches. So for our next round, we want to keep this nice and flat so we don't have the cone head. So we're going to do another tall chain, lock it in, and then two double crochets again in that slip stitch. So our hole is nice and large to see, to work into. And we're doing another 12 increases, another 12 sets of two double crochets, but we're spacing them out evenly so that our circle stays a circle. If I just put all my increases on one half of this beanie, I would start getting a weird bulb out of the side of it. So to space it out, I need to add a double crochet in between each increase. So I'm going to do one double crochet in my next stitch. And then I'm going to do two double crochets in the stitch after. So my pattern is two double crochets and then a double crochet. And I do that 12 times. So you'll see brackets in the pattern, and that means do what you see in the brackets as many times as it tells you after the brackets. So it says DC two times in next stitch, DC in next stitch. So that means two in one and then one in one, over and over. Basically, it's until you get to the end of the round, but I put in there 12 times just in case you want to keep track. So we'll keep going around until we get back to the beginning. I have just my last double crochet to do. And we are ready to join. Again, skip that tall chain and insert your hook there. You should have 36 stitches this time, so if you need to check your stitches or work your way backwards for the join, go ahead and do that. So you can see, if I didn't have this here and I kind of just showed you the top of this, that seam is very masked. It doesn't stand out like a normal chain three join seam. So it'll really help make it look a lot nicer when your project is finished. So for the next round, we're gonna do some more increases. Again, we have to do another 12. So we're gonna start with the tall chain, lock it in, two double crochets. This time, since we spaced out our two double crochets by one double crochet last time, now we're spacing it out by two. So I'm going to do one double crochet in my next stitch, and then one double crochet in the stitch after. So it's increase or DC two times in next stitch, and then DC in next two stitches, which means one DC in each of the next two stitches. So you'll see that in the brackets again in the pattern. So you can kind of start to understand how these patterns go if you're new. I tend to talk a lot in these videos because I, just in case this is the first one you've ever watched from me, I'm hoping that you'll learn something. People that watch my videos a lot are probably hearing a lot of the same info, but I want to make sure that you have enough information rather than not enough. So sorry if you do not like the talking. I try to give as much information as possible. So again, we're doing two double crochets in one stitch, and then one double crochet in the next two stitches. That's going to keep us flat. We're almost ready to get to the body. So you notice I just kind of took a little pause because I couldn't remember what stitch I was on. So when I do that, I'm pulling my stitches apart to look, because you can see there's a V coming out of this stitch. You can see the two stitches actually coming out of that stitch. and then you can see the one and the one. So if you're stitching and you put it down and you pick it up and you're like, oh my goodness, where was I? Instead of having to count all the way from the beginning to see what you should be on, just pull them apart and you can see it right there. So even if I look at the round below, you can see here's two coming out of one and one, two and one. So you can read your stitches really well in double crochet to help you see where you're at. So we're gonna keep going around until we get back to the beginning. Okay, I'm just on my last two double crochets. And then we are going to move on to the body of the beanie. If you want to make this slightly bigger, so this is good for a newborn. This is going to give you about a 15 inch circumference, and there'll be a little bit of stretch. So that's usually about a newborn size head. So really cute and like a little baby shower gift basket. But if you want to make it a little bit more practical so that it'll last a little bit longer, you can do one more round. So you're going to do the two double crochets increase, and this time you'll put three double crochets in between. So it'd be DC two times, DC in the next three, and then DC two times. So right now we have 48 stitches. If you went one more round, you would have 60 stitches. So if you want to make it to, that'll probably give you about a 17 inch circumference, 16 to 17, and that should last a few more months. The stretch on this is good with it being double crochet, so you're going to get a pretty good stretch all the way probably up to about a 17 inch circumference. But if you get, because this is unstretched, this is 15 inches unstretched, so if you go one more round, you'll probably get about 17 inches unstretched, which will get you about 18, 19 with the stretch. So that's the measurement around the head, like right above the ears. So around the whole, like if this is the head and this is the eyes, you're doing the measurement around this way. Okay, so now we're ready for the body. Basically, super simple. We're gonna do a tall chain, and then we're gonna double crochet in every stitch we come to, and that is it. Super simple, no increasing, just start double crocheting in every stitch. All right, my last double crochet. So if you're here and you're like, I don't know where to end my double crochet, should I work here or whatever it may be, just remember how many stitches around you have. So this specific beanie has 48, so I can count 48 to make sure that I have the correct amount before joining. So sometimes that will throw off somebody that's new. They think they might need to work here, wherever it may be. Just count your stitches real quick and you'll be able to see where you should end. So again, we're gonna join, and you'll notice that we're starting to form a little bowl. So this is the way we wanna work it. We wanna work it with the bowl facing out and our stitches work facing out. Some people will work it this way. It does not matter, whatever's more comfortable for you, but you'll notice that the correct side of the stitches are on the inside. So when you're done, you just flip it out. It's, even if you like this side better, this kind of gives a little bit of a different texture. Whatever you like, there's no wrong in crochet. But if you want to be technically correct, you would work it like a bowl with the stitches facing to the outside, not the inside. So you'll see it's starting to cup up. We're starting to get a beanie shape. And now we're just going to do the same thing again. Tall chain, lock it in, double crochet around. Super simple. So go ahead and work all the way around, and we'll meet up again at the last end. Double crochet. We can see how this is taking shape. So you're getting a good little bowl here. So we're going to do two more rounds of the same thing with the tall chain and double crochet all the way around. We don't need to keep coming back at the end of the round. You know what to do. So go ahead and do two more rounds, and then we will come back and look at the beanie. I've done my last double crochet. Now I'm ready to join up. So I did two more rounds of the double crochet. Now we've got the full beanie. We're just going to do one more round of finishing. So we're going to do a round of single crochet, so that way it gives it like a finished edge around the bottom. So we're going to do a chain one, and then we're going to single crochet in that same stitch as the join. And that keeps our seam all straight. If I were to move it over one and start in the next stitch, my seam would go that way. It's not really noticeable, but it's a good habit to be in when you're doing single crochet, so that you always have a straight seam. You always work your first single crochet in the same stitch as your chain one. So we're just going to single crochet around. So we insert our hook, yarn over, pull up, and pull through both, and that is it for the single crochet. So we'll go around and then we'll meet at the end and get ready to make our ears. The last single crochet. Again, if you're having trouble telling where your last one goes, just count those V's, because the single crochets, unless you're used to counting them, they're a little bit more difficult. Each little V that you see in the front is a single crochet, but just turning your work and counting the V's on top is a lot easier. So we're going to join with a slip stitch in the top of our very first single crochet, and then we're going to fasten off. So I always do my fasten off, so I make a chain and then I pull it long and cut that loop, and then pull out the extra yarn from my ball. Just pull that tight. Now we have our beanie complete. You can see a nice little edge. And now we just need to make our ears. So we're going to use the same color. You can get creative if you want and use other colors. All right,
so now to start on the ears, we're going to do another magic adjustable loop. This time we're using single crochet instead of double crochet. So again, grab your tail and turn down and grab hold. I'm going to do a slip stitch this time just to lock it down. The magic adjustable loop or the magic adjustable ring is pretty unruly until you get the hang of it. It wants to fight you with every stitch. So just notice how many fingers I'm using to hold on to it as I make my single crochet. So let me go ahead and actually do a chain one first, just to get a little height. Then I'm going to single crochet 6 times in the ring. And notice I pull everything, straighten everything out, move the ring around. You'll get used to it as you practice. But if you hold on to it, it's a lot easier to make your single crochets around. So we have 5. This is even harder to count, these single crochets, than a dark color. So use the tops of your stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm gonna make one more. I thought I had already made 6. And 6, and then pull it tight. So we're working in a spiral for this. So I have a stitch marker. I don't wanna join the rounds. I want this to be no seams on it. So I'm gonna start doing my single crochet just as if I had joined the round. So I want to do it in the first single crochet I made. So again, you can count backwards to find that. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then we have our chain one over here. So make sure you're not working into that chain one. Then I'm going to single crochet. Did I do? 1, 2. I did make 6. Just kidding, because this is my chain one right here, and that's my single crochet. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Always good to count. And I'm going to add, I'm going to do a single crochet here. We're going to increase, so we're doing 2 single crochets in every stitch. So you go back in there and make another one, but I'm going to put my stitch marker in so I don't lose track of my round. I'm putting it in the first stitch I made for this round right here, so that I know when to start the next round instructions. Some people like to put the stitch marker in the last stitch of their previous round. I don't like doing that because I get on a roll with my instructions and I don't want to have to stop at my last stitch to pull the stitch marker out. So I need to do 2 single crochets in each stitch around. Get caught there. So counting, unless you're sitting there and not moving for this entire ear, I would use a stitch marker. You can also use yarn as your stitch marker. Just lay the yarn down in between, right on top of your stitch before you make it, and then make your stitch and it'll get locked in. And then you can just pull it out when you get to the next round. But if I had my stitch marker right in this stitch, this last stitch, I would have to stop and take it out. Instead, I finished my whole round, and then I can look at my pattern and go, okay, next round, this is what I'm doing, and I can take out my stitch marker as I'm looking at my pattern. It's a lot more convenient for me, at least, to do that. So the next round, we're going to increase again, but we're going to put a single crochet in between each increase, just kind of like we did with the double crochet increases. So I'm doing two single crochets in this first stitch. Again, put my stitch marker back. Ouch. This is a pokey stitch marker. It's like a safety pin. Very sharp. Then I'm going to do one single crochet in my next stitch. Then two single crochets in the next stitch. And a single crochet in the next stitch. And repeat that pattern around until we get back to the beginning. All right, I'm back to the beginning. Got my stitch marker, so I'm gonna pull this out, and then I'm looking at my pattern as I pull it out. And this time we're moving our increases just a little bit because I want to make sure that this stays looking like a circle instead of a hexagon. If I keep my increases in the same spot every time, it's gonna get more of a hexagon shape than a circle shape. So this time I'm gonna single crochet once into that first stitch. We're still evenly increasing around. We're just moving them one stitch over. So instead of increasing in that very first stitch, I'm doing an increase in the next stitch. So I'm gonna do two single crochets in this next stitch, and then one single crochet in the next stitch. So instead of doing two single crochets in this first stitch and then one and one, I'm doing one, two single crochets and one. So that's the pattern. Single, SC two times, single. So just remember that. That'll help you to keep a more rounded look to the top of the ear. So two and then one. One single crochet, two single crochets, and one single crochet. So keep doing that all the way around back to the stitch mark. One more round to go. You can see even with that movement, we still have kind of a little bit of a hexagon shape. But once we do this next round, boy, that is fuzzy. Hold on. There we go. Once we do the next round, we are going to have a more circle shape. So for this next round, all we're doing is single crocheting in every stitch around. So this is our final round before we start making it 3D. So again, place your stitch marker. I keep stabbing myself. This thing is pointy. Do not recommend this thing. And then just single crochet in each stitch around. So do that, and we'll meet up at the end of the round. All right, so finish that round. Before I start this next round, because the next round is going to start decreasing it, I want to weave in this end just a bit, because I'm actually going to hide it inside, so I don't have to weave it in totally. But I want to make sure that this hole is completely closed for the ear. So I'm going to grab my yarn needle. Back. And then I'm going to pull that close so you can see there's a little bit of a hole there. I want to close it all the way up, and then I'm going to weave my yarn through the middle of all those single crochets here. So that way that hole will stay closed, because a lot of amigurumi patterns, they'll say, oh, just tuck it inside, but they don't remind you to kind of weave it in so that hole stays closed. So if you have any amigurumi and your hole's starting to open, that's why, because you didn't take that one extra step real quick to close that off. Now, I am just gonna cut that, leave that little guy there, because that's gonna remind me that this is the inside. I don't want this part facing out. I want this part facing out. So you'll see it's cupping around like this. I need to cup it around the other way. And now I'm starting to decrease. Decreases don't matter for the circular effect because we already finished that round. You can see it looks like a circle, so we're good to go.
So the decreases are all going to be made the same way. We're going to decrease the first two stitches, so we're going to SC2TOG, single crochet two together. So to do that, just in case you are not familiar, you're going to insert your hook in the first stitch you come to, pull up a loop, insert your hook in the next stitch you come to, pull up a loop. You have three loops on your hook, just like a half double crochet, and you're going to yarn over and pull through all three. Then we're going to copy what we did for the round before this last round, where we did two single crochets and then two crochets and one. I cannot say it correctly. We did two single crochets in one stitch, and then we did one single crochet in the next two stitches. So this is a reverse. We're doing SC two together, and then we're doing one single crochet in the next two stitches. So it's just kind of reverse. Instead of increasing, we're decreasing. So when you do your decrease, turn your hook down to pull through. You won't get caught on all your loops. And then two single crochets. And this is going to start cupping up right away. So you can see it's cupping the wrong way. So just keep flipping it back around because we want this part facing out. So again, single crochet two together. And then single crochet once in the next two stitches. All right, we have 18 stitches now. We're gonna get down to 12 and we're gonna be done. Then we're gonna put this on our beanie. So to get down to 12, we're gonna decrease again. This time we're gonna again do a single crochet two together. And this time we're gonna do one single crochet in our next stitch. And then we'll start the pattern over. In there, stabbed myself again. Yowza. Okay, single crochet two together, one single crochet, two together, one. I'll just keep going because I'm almost there, halfway there. So you notice I kind of pushed it and pull it and move it so that I can get this. So I can work into it while it's folded over. So I got a little, I just push it out of the way so that I don't actually catch any of these stitches when I'm making the current stitch. So I kind of move it, pull it, push it, and get it out of the way. Let's see, two together, single crochet. Should have one left, I think. Yep. Okay. And whoops, I did a single crochet instead. Let me fix that. And we're there. Okay, so we're gonna fasten off. Get a long tail for easy sewing. As long as you need it. I always need it about 10 times longer than everybody else because I am. I don't like to like cut another piece of yarn. I just want to be able to do it all with one. So pull off this guy. We're going to get a little bit of polyfill. If you don't have polyfill, because it uses such a small amount, like this is it for 1 year. If you don't have polyfill and don't want to go buy a big gigantic bag of it, use yarn scraps. Just grab some yarn and stuff it in until it's poofy enough that you like it. So, I think I need a little bit more. Grab some. And I want it sticking out just a bit. That's how poofy I want it. So it's a big hole, easy to stuff. I've already made one of these and attached it to my beanie. So I haven't woven in all of my edges yet. But I put one of our ears on, and I did it where the seam is. And the reason that I put it on the seam is because when you're going to put this on a baby, you don't want to have to worry about is the seam in the front or the back. So sometimes they'll put the ears and have the seam in the middle, and you're supposed to always put, you know, that in the back so it's cute. If you put the ear on the seam, you don't have to worry about that. Both sides are good. And you really can't tell because the ear takes up most of the seam. So it's a win-win. So that is my tip for the day. All right, now we're gonna sew this other guy on. So I went between, I sewed it on, so here's round one, round two. I sewed this guy on from round 3, 4, and a little bit around 5. So I wanted him kind of right on top of the head. So we're gonna place it. I am doing the part that I'm starting right where I need it to be. So don't start like sideways over here and then hope that it winds up in the right place up top. Start it where exactly you want it to be. So I'm gonna come straight across and I want it right there at round 3. And I'm going to go into the stitch. We're gonna whip stitch this. So it's gonna go around and around. So I go into the stitch and then I'm gonna catch some yarn on the beanie. I do not go all the way through. That's just a hole of one of the stitches. The actual needle is in, or that's the actual needle sticking through right there. The actual needle is in between the yarn. I'm breaking the yarn when I sew. So it's called when you go through the plies. So that way I don't create any gaps. If I go all the way around a stitch and I pull it tight, I'm gonna create a gap like that. So I wanna break the yarn, go through the plies, so that way it's not going to create any weird holes. So I'm gonna keep on checking this. I'm gonna keep adjusting it as I go so that I know my ears are looking good. Because you have some wiggle room in the beginning. Once you get halfway, 3/4 through, your ears are not moving. So again, I'm going to the next stitch, and then I'm going and breaking some plies, and then I pull it through. Go to the next stitch. More stitches than less stitches is better. Do as many as you can for a nice seamless ear. So you can see I did all the way around the bottom. So again, go through the loop, go through some yarn, and pull. Again, I'm gonna check this, make sure it's going where I want it to go. I'm liking where it's at. It's looking good. Probably turn it this way just so I can keep an eye on it. So go through the loop, break some plies. Oops, not too many. And then pull. Again, through the loop, break some plies. I think you get the gist of it. Pull it nice and tight. And this will create a nice seamless look to your beanie. To the ears in the beanie. So keep going until you get all the way around, and then we'll weave in the rest of the ends and take a look at our finished beanie. All right, I've finished doing all of the whip stitching. And you can go around a couple times if you want. You can secure it as much as you want. If you want this not to be so poofy, you can stitch a little higher and pull it down, whatever you like. Once you get it all the way around, just run it through and then come out the other side. And I am queen of the double knots. I love double knotting stuff to get it so secure. So if there's a spot where I can double knot, I always double knot. And some people just hate that, but I don't have to worry about it coming undone. So I am gonna weave my end all the way to the center. I already did this with the other ear, but I totally wove it in so you can't see it. But I'm going over to my middle yarn that I started the project with. And I'm getting right next to it, and I'm gonna double knot it. And then I'm gonna weave it in some more. So I'm gonna leave my needle on, double knot this guy. That's why I have it woven this in, because I wanna use it for double knotting. And then I'm gonna go and go back the other way. And I don't really need to weave this part in that much. Since I double knotted it, it's not going to come undone, but I want to do it a little bit. All right, so I only have these two other ends to weave in. So I'll do that real quick, just in case you're new to weaving in. I always like when this center hole, I double knotted it really tight, so this center hole is not going to open, but usually I will go around just like I did with the ear. And it's really thick right here, so it's a good spot to hide your ends. You can get to this center hole on anything you're working in the round It's a great spot to hide all of the ends of your yarn. And since I double knotted this as well, I don't have to weave in that much because it's not going to come undone either. So the only place I want to be real careful is over here on this end. So very last one. I'm going to go in the direction that I was working. So if I look this way, I'm going that way. So I want to go into this next stitch. I'm going to go right in the middle and start working my way up, because that's going to help bring down that fasten, that little fasten off piece to hide it. And then I'm going to go through these stitches. And you break the ply on these. Don't go, you want to go in the middle of the stitches so that you don't have any yarn tails showing through. So let's see, almost there. You can weave in as much as you want, but going back and forth will help kind of lock it in really well. Okay, so I'll cut that off. Now we have our little beanie. It's so cute. I like the poofy on the ears. You can even like maybe put them right on the sides if you're a Star Wars fan, or make them a little bigger and have little Princess Leia buns. But that is our baby bear beanie. If you have any questions, leave them below, and thank you for watching.